Over the past 1,000 episodes of Studio 10, we have welcomed more than 5,000 guests through those Studio 10 doors, creating many memorable moments. So now it's time to check out our best celeb in-studio interviews. Let's do it. I'm allowed at the party.
Oh. Hello.
Oh, I just sat on my mic.
You nearly crashed through the fourth wall there, didn't you?
Oh, I just had to break it. Now, we're talking about massive celeb interviews that we've had here. Mm. And none were bigger than episode 17. Doesn't that seem like a long time?
17?
Yeah, yeah. Oh. Feels like 4 years ago, doesn't it, Denise?
Yes, it does. Oh,
yes. I knew you'd agree with me. Something happened with you, Joe, that was very interesting.
Let me see. If I remember episode 17, that would be when we had Jesse Tyler Ferguson on.
That's exactly right. And he was trying to put a tie on you, but it didn't go to plan.
What is that? You bought the shirt and you have this on it. What is going on with you?
Oh. Are you meant to take
those off? You're supposed to throw this away when you buy the shirt. Oh, you're a disaster. I don't know if I can.
This would explain my bone experiencing neck pain for the last 20 years.
You know what? I'm done with you.
Joe, would you say that you were a functioning adult or?
I'm not sure if anything about me is functioning, but yeah, I didn't realise you were meant to take those cardboard things out. I thought that was just, but you know, you learn something every 20 years.
He doesn't like ironing his shirts.
No, oh. That's right. That's why I have people to do that for me.
Oh, wow. Well, Sarah Harris, you've shared some memorable moments on the show.
Have I?
You have. And one of those was with your teen crush, the one and only Scott Wolf.
How do you do the kiss, Scott?
should we do
it? Yeah.
They talk about regrets on your deathbed. That will definitely be a regret of mine, just not launching in for the passion. Oh. I reckon Tom would have been all right with it.
I was going to ask you, does Tom know?
Celebrities don't count.
No.
Oh, yes, they do.
Is he your celebrity hall pass, Sarah?
Oh, no, I don't really have one, but he's so handsome.
He is handsome,
he's
that's right.
So handsome.
And there was an amazing second there, split second, where you
thought
actually thought he was
going to. It looked like I was going to eat his face off.
Now, I'm not sure if I've mentioned this at all, but I was in a few episodes of The Bold and the Beautiful.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I've never mentioned
that. Oh, yeah. When was that, darling?
A couple of months ago. I didn't want to make too much of a fuss, but I was also joined by the wonderful Ida Buttrose and Angela Bishop, and they came down to Australia to film some of the episodes for the series, and we're going to watch them in full right now.
I'm in the back, and I hope they're still conscious. Hold on a little bit.
They survived the very bumpy ride that they had when they were coming into the studio there. I mean, it was precious cargo, but I was just too excited, really, and I don't have a licence. But I didn't tell that prior. Yeah, that happened. I understand he's okay now, though.
They were great.
They were so much fun. But here's what happened when they popped by our little studio.
What's it like, Ridge, doing a sex scene? Is it a bit strange?
It's strange for me because my wife has to do it.
On the show.
Unlike this guy, you get to a certain point in life where you want to keep your shirt on. I don't know what he does or
do you
what
want to take
it,
do you want to take your shirt off for the audience?
You know he does.
Yes. Oh. Maybe later.
We can work it out. You guys take yours off.
Recurring theme, isn't there? Just when you're in public, you want to take your clothes off.
Yeah, we have a saying in our family, never dare a Hildebrand to get naked.
I will never do that. Now, my Big Fat Greek Wedding writer and actress Nia Vardalos joined us live in the studio to talk about the much-awaited sequel. Take a look at what happened.
But you know, Greeks are very inclusive. If you've just been to Greece or had a piece of feta cheese, we're like, you're Greek.
I had feta cheese yesterday. I'm Greek.
Yes, you are. You are. I'll check you for chin hairs later. And we're really Greek.
Now, that is something I want to see. You checking on for chin hairs.
Trapped alive.
I don't think you're a Greek. I think you're all right. Just touch your chin hairs there. They're all right.
Oh, thank you.
Paddy Newton hair's been taken out, hasn't it?
Oh, yeah, that's been plucked. for today, eh?
All right, well, when chatty man Alan Carr visited us on the show, like most of us, he had no idea what was happening or what he was in for.
Oh, this is so
Take a look at this.
We're going to release Alan Carr into the studio audience.
Okay.
Now!
To Alan straight after that, and he was genuinely shocked. He was sweaty, he was out of breath, and he's like, what kind of show is this?
He was a great guest, though.
Oh, he was great. No, he's
fantastic.
Brilliant.
Really
was so good. We've actually had people coming through on social media talking to me saying, can you show the Alan Carr thing? Can you show the Alan Carr thing? They loved him. He was amazing.
Yeah, he was brilliant.
He was absolutely amazing. Now, who could forget Jason Isaac when he read us, I'm still tinkling from it, 50 Shades of Grey.
It's a long time since I've seen pubic hair up close and personal like this. I tug it gently. Perhaps we'll keep this, though it's no good for wax play. An image of her shackled to my bench, peeled ginger root inserted in her so she can't clench her buttocks, comes to mind, followed by judicious use of a belt or strap. She looks radiant, my agrees, and stiffens in greeting.
Fun fact.
Yeah.
I actually fell pregnant after that.
Oh, wow. That's how good he is.
He's excellent.
Just wow.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay.
I wasn't there for that show. I think it's just as well.
Well, we all remember Christopher Atkins became an instant heartthrob thanks to the film The Blue Lagoon. But when he visited us, in the studio, he also proved he was up for a laugh.
Christopher, what are kitchen benches used for?
I think that's where you make babies. Oh, now, speaking of babies, where's JJ? Mommy! 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 Oh, good night, Christopher. Mommy!
I will never get tired of seeing Jonathan Coleman without a shirt on. It is just, it's a national treasure. It really
timeless.
Is.
It's
yeah.
It's timeless.
And finally, I may have gone a little overboard with my declaration of love for music star Josh Groban.
Hello, Mr. Groban. Thank you so much. I love you. How are you?
Good morning.
Good morning to you. My name's Robbo. Welcome to the outside of the studio.
It's glorious. The rain stopped for just a minute.
Just for us.
Yeah, and it smells fresh and green.
That's me.
Is that you?
Yes. Yeah, it's an earthy time. Yeah. Come with me now as I bring you in. Yes. Oh, no, you're not supposed to notice that yet. That was just a rehearsal.
Oh, it was a rehearsal?
Yeah. Yeah. But you did that really good. Can you
fall from the trees here?
They fell from my heart. I don't know where I'm getting these lines. I hope you're writing them down.
I'm blushing.
I'm blushing too. Now, Mr. Groban, how have you enjoyed Australia so far?
It's been wonderful. I love it here. Very, very musical country. The fans here have been wonderful. I'm excited to be here.
Oh, hold on one second, just a minute. This is dark grey ground. That's boring.
Oh,
so,
we got more.
Yeah. As we come through here, can you smell that? I mean, some of them are fake.
I feel like I need to do the princess wave while you do that.
Well, one of us is going to have to do that wave.
Yeah, exactly.
Come through with me anyway.
Well, the rest is so, I feel, is so well designed here. Yeah.
It seems like a shed, but it only seems that way.
I like the Shell science.
Well, we've got to pay the bills somehow.
Exactly.
Technology hub there.
Exactly right, yes.
Do you love Shell Helix?
No opinion one way or the other.
I need to hear you say you love Shell Helix.
I love Shell Helix.
Fantastic, so do I. Hopefully I get some money from that.
I get free Shell Helix from now on?
I hope so.
Walk places.
Oh, good. Okay, now I've got some premium Australian champagne here for your arrival, which is, of course, the Passion Pop. Have you heard of Passion Pop before?
I don't know.
Well, just one second. Let me just...
I'm a big fan of that man.
Oh,
it was so much fun. It was so much fun.
He was a really nice guy. I think he spent, I don't know, about 4 hours with us on the show.
Yeah,
it was a lot of time.
Well, we did tether him to the set.
I think he's still here, actually.
Yeah, right.
At the back somewhere.
You have to feed him three times a day. It's a real...
Oh, it's tough. It's tough having kids. Sarah Harris.
Oh, look, that was great, Robbo.
Thank you very much.
Wander down memory lane.